Getting a ticket can be a traumatic experience. You suddenly owe hundreds of dollars to the court and possibly thousands of dollars in additional auto insurance over the next few years. This video will explain how the Ticket Assassin can help you fight your traffic ticket entirely by mail. How to contest your California traffic ticket with the Ticket Assassin. Once you've received a ticket, you have two options: give up and send in your money, or contest. Sending in your money is the same as pleading guilty. By giving up and pleading guilty, the court will require you to pay the maximum fine allowed by law and will record a conviction on your public DMV record for 5 years. A conviction on your record will increase your auto insurance by an average of $300 per year for 3 to 5 years. Pleading guilty is the worst possible option to choose. Or you can choose to plead not guilty and contest. Contesting your traffic ticket is your only chance for total victory. If you win, you pay no fine, and you have no conviction recorded on your DMV record. Only fighting a citation can provide total vindication for an unfairly cited citizen. Amazingly, less than 1% of defendants contest their citation. Why do so few people fight? Why? Because our traffic courts make contesting your ticket seem inconvenient and scary. Arrest warrant, license suspension, civil assessment, these are the fascist threats made in your so-called courtesy notice. The court makes contesting seem extremely difficult and terribly inconvenient. The court bullies defendants just like you into pleading guilty without putting up a fight. By contrast, paying the fine could not be easier. Almost every court in the state allows you to pay online with a credit card. A couple of weeks after you get your ticket, you'll receive a courtesy notice from the court. Now, most people get the impression from their courtesy notice that fighting the ticket is a multiple-step process where you have to take days off of work. One day off just to go in and plead not guilty. Then another day off work just to go in and argue your case in front of an angry judge. For most people, 2 days off of work is a lot of money. For some, that's almost as much as the ticket itself. There's a better way. The law allows you to contest your traffic ticket entirely by mail. It's called the trial by written declaration. California Vehicle Code 40519B is the law that allows you to contest your traffic ticket in writing through the mail. This is exactly what it sounds like. You have the right to have your trial in writing by arguing your case in writing and sending it to the court by mail. How does it work? Well, in a nutshell, you fill out your trial by written declaration form. In the form, you argue the facts of your case. In your declaration, you state why you are not guilty of the vehicle code violation the officer alleges you violated. Then, you print it out onto the right form, then you sign it, then you mail it to the court, then you cross your fingers, and that's it. You can find more specific directions on how to fill out your declaration, including tons of example declarations and different arguments and strategies on TicketAssassin.com. There are many advantages to fighting your ticket using a trial by written declaration. You can contest your citation without appearing at all. No days off of work. You stand a better chance of winning than you would if you went into court and fought it out with a cop and a judge. And if you lose your declaration, you can have the judgment set aside and request a new trial in person. That's right. If you lose your trial by written declaration, you get a free do-over. That's an extra chance at winning. When you request a trial by written declaration, you are given a few weeks to write it and turn it in. The officer has to turn one in as well. If the officer turns in a declaration, you have a much better chance of a favorable judgment than arguing with the officer in court. The officer will not be able to refresh his memory of your case without seeing your face again in court. After writing 200 to 300 citations per month, it's difficult for any officer to remember the specific details of your particular stop. Since you remember many more details of the stop much clearer than the officer, you can therefore write a much better, more detailed declaration. Also, the intimidation that many people feel in meeting the officer in a formal setting of court trial is eliminated by drafting a written declaration in the privacy and security of your own home. The result? Most defendants are able to present a stronger case in writing than in person. In a trial by written declaration, the judge is able to assess the case fairly and separately in his chambers. The judge's decisions can be based on the merits of the case alone, unbiased by the social circus that is the California Traffic Court. Even if the judge finds you guilty, he may suspend or reduce your fine and assign you to attend traffic school. In a court trial, fine suspensions are rare and fine reductions are smaller. Judges find it difficult to reduce fines drastically in a court crowded with defendants, all expecting the same good deal. The most obvious advantage: the officer gets paid $300 in overtime to show up in person at a court trial, but gets paid nothing to complete this declaration paperwork. In our experience, about 30% of police officers fail to submit a response to the court by the deadline. If the officer does not turn in his declaration on time, your case is dismissed. You win! By simply contesting by written declaration, you stand a decent chance of dismissal regardless of your argument. A friend we know submitted a written declaration for speeding on the freeway. He was driving 93 in a 65, clearly in violation of the law. On his written declaration, he wrote, "I'm not guilty" with orange crayon, misspelling guilty. The officer cited him, did not respond. Our friend received a dismissal notice a couple weeks later, and then he took us out to lunch. Nice guy. There are many disadvantages to an in-person court trial. Most people are too nervous to represent themselves well in court. Also, since most defendants are inexperienced with the law, they tend to lose their cases. This steady stream of guilty verdicts may predispose the judge to find you guilty as well, even if your case is well argued. Another disadvantage to an in-person court trial is that you are not entitled to a jury. Since 1968, traffic infraction defendants are entitled to a trial decided by a judge alone. Court trial is a one-shot deal. If you are found guilty, you have no right to a new trial. Another disadvantage to an in-person court trial is that the citing officer testifies against you and also acts as prosecutor. Officers are usually called in to trial on their days off and receive $300 in overtime pay for their brief appearance. That's enough money to buy him 720 regular donuts or 579 fancy donuts, you know, bear claws, apple fritters, eclairs, etc. As a result, cops usually make it to court. Traffic court judges tend to be consistent, if not fair. You may be found guilty with the other defendants, even though you have a solid case for dismissal. Many judges choose to favor the officer in open court to avoid embarrassing him before a crowd of gawking rubes. Our mission at the Ticket Assassin is to make all California citizens aware of their legal right to contest traffic citations and to encourage and empower citizens to fight traffic tickets through knowledge of their legal rights under the California Vehicle Code. Through this informed citizenry, our aim is to return California's money-corrupted traffic courts to their legitimate function as courts of justice. Now, we want you to fight your ticket, and we want you to win. We've provided many of the forms you'll need on this website, along with a ton of written declaration examples that tens of thousands of ticketed Californians have used since 1999 to beat their ticket. To access our forms and examples, we charge a membership fee of $25. Our site works on the shareware model. That means you get access to the material first, and then you pay later. Payment is all on the honor system. When you register on the site, you are granted access to the premium content on the site. We only ask that you pay within 10 days. Again, honor system. For 1 year after you become a paid member, you get unlimited access to our Put a Hit on Your Ticket shareware forms and examples. You also get expert answers to your questions with detailed guidance on contesting your ticket, including all necessary court forms. You get tons of detailed examples of previously successful written declarations for the most common moving violations. Also, you get priority email access to me and others at the Ticket Assassin compound as we fight your ticket. As an added enticement to become a member, we have some example declarations and strategies that we only send to people who have become members. These include newer types of tickets like cell phone tickets and red light camera tickets. Regardless of whether or not you become a Ticket Assassin member, I encourage you to fight your ticket. Everyone in our country has a right to a vigorous defense against criminal allegations. That includes you. You have a right to defend yourself. I created this site to help you, the California motorist, defend yourself against unfair traffic tickets. If your ticket is unfair and you want to fight it, this site is for you. Fight!